So, with news emerging that former Chief of Staff of the Jamaica Defense Force, Major General Anthony Anderson, has been selected as the next Commissioner of Police effective the 19th of March 2018, many persons might have been wondering what is now going through the head of one Renita Adams, who many persons wished was given the opportunity to become the country's Chief Constable. Renita Adams takes high road after police commissioner job snub.
Teach them! Always make sure the message reach them!
Controversial retired cop Renita Adams is taking the high road after being overlooked again for the post of police commissioner. Adams was among the candidates for the job to tackle the country's crime monster. He had applied following overwhelming calls from members of the public for him to take up the position. However, on Tuesday, March 6th, the colorful character saw his hopes dashed following the announcement that Major General Anthony Anderson, the National Security Advisor to Prime Minister Andrew Holness, was selected to fill the void left by former Commissioner George Quaylo, who retired in February. Adams said that he would not be giving up on Jamaica, despite being snubbed for a third time in a selection process for the nation's top cop. "I will definitely not be giving up on Jamaica and its people. I just love Jamaica and love to help the people," said Adams. He said instead of feeling disappointed, he would rise above the setback. "Every challenge that I have confronted has propelled me, whether it came out of positive or negative, to another level of motivation," said Adams. He explained that applying for the police commissioner job was never to make money, but to make a difference. Adams, now 68 years old, retired from the Jamaica Constabulary Force in June 2008 after spending close to 41 years in the organization.
You know, it's Teach Them, the number one intellectual blogging panel on the YouTube channel.
The truth of the matter is that Adams' past hangs over him same way, and many persons in Jamaica are not in favor of him becoming commissioner. Many persons stand to lose too much, and many persons' toes would be stepped on. Among his more noted roles in the JCF was as head of the paramilitary style crime management unit, which specialized in heavy-handed policing that clearly drove fear into the minds of criminals across the country. Consequently, the mere presence of members of his unit in hotspots would quickly and significantly reduce serious criminal activities. Seen as a hero in some communities and among most Jamaicans, judging by polling results over the years, he was also identified in some circles as being highly controversial. For example, he was associated with bloody, violent incidents such as a shootout between police and gunmen that left 27 people dead in West Kingston in July 2001, the killing of seven young men at a house in Brayton, St. Catherine, 4 months before, and the deaths of four people in a house in Crawl District, Clarendon, 2 years later. In all cases, Adams insisted that his life and those of the men and women under his command came in danger, and the law enforcers were forced to defend themselves. He and his team members were cleared of all allegations of criminal responsibilities in each instance.
"I will not recommend a solution, no, but what I can say, Jamaica will pay dearly, dearly for this."
Like, subscribe, and don't forget to click the notification button. Hey yo, we always up to something.
This video was made possible through the continued generosity of my patrons. To become a patron, follow the link in the description below.
Teach them! Hey yo, hello! Send the message and make it reach them. It's Teach Them, right here, Warlord representing.
Thank you for watching. Please leave a comment below. Remember to like and share the video. Don't forget to subscribe for more awesome content. Follow me on social media and check out the suggested videos on screen. This is Teach saying, until next time, walk good, my friends.